Now, this is a really, really interesting article that we're going to be jumping into in regards to a new online poll. Now, this isn't just any old poll. This isn't just some poll that some random person put out there. This is a poll from Netflix. Netflix put this poll out. And so this is, you know, a pretty legitimate poll. I'm excited to be jumping into this because I never thought that I would see this day where Lord of the Rings beats out Star Wars. Now, we all know the reasons why this is happening. We all know why Lord of the Rings is beating out Star Wars at this point. That is because Star Wars is a flaming pile of garbage right now. So let's go ahead and get into this poll here. A new poll from the Next on Netflix Twitter account sees the Lord of the Rings franchise trounce Star Wars. Fans were given the option to choose between Star Wars and Lord of the Rings, and they overwhelmingly chose chose Lord of the Rings. 61% voted for Lord of the Rings, while only 39% voted for Star Wars. 38,000 people participated in the poll. What makes the poll even more interesting is that it was conducted by Netflix, who doesn't really have a stake in either of these franchises. Disney runs Star Wars, and Amazon will be putting out a new Lord of the Rings TV series. It would have been hard to imagine Star Wars losing to Lord of the Rings in a poll like this just a few short years ago. And that's really funny, because I even remember in Geeks and Gamers, some people put out some polls like, you know, Star Wars, Lord of the Rings, which one would you choose? All that type of stuff. And Star Wars pretty much always beat out Lord of the Rings. Now, I was always the one who voted for Lord of the Rings because I am completely loyal to Lord of the Rings, and I think Lord of the Rings is the best. And I don't think even Star Wars can touch Lord of the Rings as far as franchises and stuff goes. So, you know, I was voting for Lord of the Rings, obviously, but there's a lot of people, most of the people voted for Star Wars. And then, you know, Force Awakens came out, and then The Last Jedi came out, and after The Last Jedi, you know, things have completely changed, and over these next couple years, or these past couple years, things have been completely flipped on its head when it comes to Star Wars. It would have been hard to imagine Star Wars losing to Lord of the Rings in a poll like this just a few short years ago, and that's exactly true. The Star Wars franchise really took a massive nosedive, to put it lightly, following Rian Johnson's The Last Jedi. The film saw Johnson utterly destroy the character of Luke Skywalker as he drank milk from the teat of an alien. So bad. Tossed aside his lightsaber, attempted to murder his nephew, and severed himself from the Force. What a complete disgrace to Luke. Absolute disgrace. Not only did the film attempt to character assassinate Luke Skywalker, but it also dismissed other iconic Star Wars characters like Admiral Ackbar. He was simply killed off by being blown out of a window. Trash. Absolute trash. But it wasn't... I just read that. Let's see here. It didn't end on the screen either. Rian Johnson would lash out at diehard Star Wars fans criticizing The Last Jedi, describing them as man-babies. Johnson would also try and blame Russian trolls, politics, and fans for the intense criticism The Last Jedi faced, instead of just owning up to the fact that he made a trash movie. Johnson would not be the only Star Wars creator to go after fans. Star Wars author and comic book writer Chuck Wendig, who also, by the way, has said some really terrible things about Lord of the Rings and J.R.R. Tolkien as well, basically saying that J.R.R. Tolkien was an overrated hack, and that he never actually was that good of a writer. Yeah, Chuck Wendig, by the way, said this. Chuck Wendig, who is a trash writer, said these things. I believe it was Chuck Wendig, if I remember correctly. Disney has not been able to stop the bleeding. In fact, their treatment of Star Wars and the treatment of Star Wars fans is now starting to affect them at the bottom line, which is true, and get woke, go broke is a real thing. We've seen that happen with Gillette fairly recently as well, where they lost over $8 billion because they went woke. So get woke, go broke is a real thing. In contrast, J.R.R. Tolkien's Lord of the Rings trilogy was faithfully adapted by director Peter Jackson. Round of applause to Peter Jackson. One of the last few actual great trilogies that have come out. I would say that Lord of the Rings and probably the new Planet of the Apes trilogy are some of the last really, really stellar, really, really well done trilogies that have come out. And I don't think that anything has even come close to touching either of those trilogies in the past couple decades. Jackson would follow up with a successful trilogy based on The Hobbit. Now, The Hobbit wasn't quite as successful. We all know that. But there's a lot of good stuff in The Hobbit movies as well. It's not complete garbage like the Star Wars sequel trilogy is. So yeah. Anyway, I am surprised that Lord of the Rings beat out Star Wars. This is probably not the way that a lot of people from, like, Netflix especially were expecting this to go, but it just goes to show how passionate people are for Lord of the Rings. Lord of the Rings has an insanely passionate fan base, which, I'm going to just say this one more time, Amazon, I am warning you. You have a choice right now to make something truly spectacular with Lord of the Rings and go in a completely different direction than Star Wars has gone. Star Wars has done nothing but disgrace the universe that George Lucas created. It has done nothing but disgrace that and completely disrespect everything having to do with Star Wars. You could go in that direction very easily with Lord of the Rings. And if you do, the same thing that's happening to Star Wars right now will happen to your Amazon series. So if you don't want that to happen, if you don't want that $1.5 billion to just go down the toilet, then you better respect Lord of the Rings. You better respect the works of Tolkien, and you better respect Middle Earth. Lord of the Rings is insanely important to a lot of people. And the Lord of the Rings fan base is insanely passionate. That's my warning to you, Amazon. With that being said, let me know in the comments below, what do you think about this poll? Are you as surprised as I am? Let me know in the comments below what you think about this, and I will talk to you all very soon in another video. Talk to you later. Bye.